Patrick, as you know, I wasn't really a rugby fan until September and October when the Rugby World Cup in England happened. It was a great production, a great tournament. I learned a lot about the sport, loved it, and was thrilled to see the All Blacks win the championship. So I was saddened Tuesday night to see that Jonah Lomu, the great All Black, had died after a long battle with health issues.
Yeah, absolutely. He, you know, it came out over a decade ago that he was having these kidney problems. He'd had them since he was a kid. Sports, of course, of explosive debut in 1995, coming in as a 20-year-old, just a kid, playing for the All Blacks, something that, you know, we'd never seen before. And certainly a guy that drew attention even from non-rugby fans. That was something that, one of the reasons why I kind of said, listen, this is something we got to get up, because even people who don't know rugby know who Jonah Lomu is.
Okay, so what was it about Jonah that made him so special?
Well, for the time, he was a physical freak. I mean, we think now, if you watch rugby now, there are lots of big wingers. You think of the All Blacks, a guy like Julian Saveo, the big, you know, 6'4", 6'5" winger. Lomu was that. He was the first time they'd ever sort of seen a guy who was 6'4", 6'5". He was 6'5", 270 pounds, playing on the wing, a fast guy, could run like the wind.
What was the more typical size of that time?
Well, I mean, you think about a guy on the wing in those days, was a guy like you. You know, little guy, quick. You know, it was not something that was kind of think of. The big guys were in the middle. They were in the scrum. They were hitting hard. You know, you think of a guy like Lomu, if he played football, and there were top rumors that, you know, the Cowboys and the Raiders had tried to bring him in at one point, but that, you know, he was the kind of guy that you'd see on the defensive line or something like that. And so here was a guy playing on the outside who was unbelievably fast. And, you know, there are some great famous moments. People talk most about the game against England in 95, where he scored four tries, ran over a bunch of people. They talk a lot about the 99 World Cup when he scored two tries against France, just, and you know, needed three, four guys to bring him down. He was so different. I mean, now guys are so big and powerful. It's less noticeable, I guess. But for his time, global superstar and just completely different and completely changed the game.
Okay, finally, is there anybody like Jonah now? Like, I mean, he was larger than life. Who on the rugby scene, if you could name one guy, is like that?
Well, I mean, I mentioned Julian Saveo as a playing type, very similar player, but I think in terms of profile, we think more of the more skilled guys. We think of Dan Carter, who may or may not be done as an All Black, you know, one of the all-time great skill players. You think of another guy like Richie McCaw, again, another New Zealand player. You know, Brian Habana, maybe as a winger from South Africa, unbelievably fast, has had the same kind of profile. Rugby is a funny game in that sense at the same time, though, because generally we don't talk too much about the individuals. There's a few stars at any one time, and Jonah Lomu, probably rugby's first global superstar.
All right, Jonah Lomu, dead at the age of 40.